गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, या लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद दी टॉपिक। इन टुडेज क्लास यू विल बी लर्निंग वन मोर न्यू फॉर्मूला रिगार्डिंग दिस फॉर्मूला, दैट इज अ जनरल फॉर्म, जनरल इक्वेशन। यू विल बी हैविंग वन मोर फॉर्मूला व्हेन दे से यू टू सॉल्व द गिवन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द लास्ट। When they ask you to solve given question from the last. For example, if you can turn the page, that is the example problem. If you can see the example problem number 8. Find the 11th term from the last term of the AP. So they'll give you the AP and they'll ask you to start solving the question from the last. At that time, what is the formula? What are you going to find? At that time, nothing is the formula. The same formula will be there. Only one thing is you are going to add an is equal to l minus n minus 1 into b. When they ask you to solve the problem from last. When they ask you to solve the problem from the last, the formula is an is equal to l minus n minus 1 into d. You know an value, that is the last term you need to find, and they'll give you which term. See here, find the 11th term. So an value will be 11. If they ask you to find the 12th term, so a 12. Find the 15th term, so it is a 15. That is number of term, nth term, what they wanted you to find. That is this L is the last value what they'll give you. That value is the L, the value, the last value. N is the number of terms what you will be writing here, that is 15, 16, 17, whatever the value. D is as usual a common difference. Okay. So for solving the last problem, when they say you to solve from the last, then what is the nth term? So we are going to write the nth term formula, nth term formula when we need to solve from last, from the last term. When we need to solve the question from the last term, we are going to write the nth term formula. What is the nth term formula? An is equal to L minus N minus 1 into D. Okay, An is equal to L minus N minus 1 into D. What is An? An is always the last term. Yes, last term. Audu adre illi last term agala. The term which you wanted to find. The term, if they ask you to find 11th term, find the 11th term from the last, find the 12th term from the last, find the 16th term from the last. So, which term they are asking, that term value I want to write. So, what shall I write? Term name, or I'll take name of the term. Name of a term. From this below only we'll solve two sums. No, you'll get to know what is that. L is the last term value. Last term quarter value. Last term value. It is not last term, it is last term value. Last term value. N is the number of terms as usual. Whatever the term here, if you take 11th term, your n value will be 11. If you take 12th term, n value will be 12. If you take 13th term, n value will be 13. Okay? So number of terms. Then D is as usual, it is a common difference where you find A2 minus A1, A3 minus A2, An minus N minus 1. An minus An minus 1 is the common difference. I hope this is clear for you. Now we are going to solve example number 8. Example number 8. Write the question in short, because if you do not have the textbook also, it's okay. I'll write the question in short. You also write it in short. Okay? Find 11th term. 11th term of from last term of an AP 10, 7, 4, it goes on up to 62. Okay, it goes on up to 62. See, children, I'm telling you again and again, example questions I won't be writing in the notes. If you want, you can copy it down. Okay, so this is the sequence they have given. Now, what is an value? An value is 11th term. You need to find. Now, we have already done an tagontaditane general agi when it was from the first. Now, we are doing it from the last. So, this is not an, this is an. So, what is an? An is equal to A11, which you should find. Okay, then what is A? A1, A2, A3. So, what is A? A is always A1, which is equal to 10. What is D? Common difference A2 minus A1, which is equal to 10, 7. 7 minus 10, which is minus 3. Yeah, 4 minus 7 is also minus 3 itself. Then, what do you want? They have told last term. So, last term and the bandi takshane. So, all the following from the last term and the bandi takshane, you should go get to your mind the formula. That is, an is equal to l minus n minus 1 into d. Do not worry. I'll always be repeating, but even you also should repeat whenever I tell you. Okay? Then, after this, what is the l? L value is the last term value, which is minus 62. Everything is there. We are going to substitute in the formula and find out the 11th term. So A11 will be L minus, sorry, An will be L minus N minus 1 into D. So A11 is equal to, what is L value? Minus 62 minus N is what, children? N is what? Very good. 11 minus 1 and D is minus 3. So it is minus 62 minus 11 minus 1 is 10 into 10 into minus 3. So it is 30. 30 into minus 30 into minus, it will be plus. So 62 plus 30. So what is the answer? Minus 32. Check. Check in your, if you have, check in your example. Check, if you have the textbook, check in your example. Is 11, A11 minus 30, 32. Yeah, this is the simplest method. Alain maadidare. They'll find using the formula L is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D and the output to N value find out maadi, amel subtract maadi, amel inda idin maadtare. I do not want those lengthy process children. This is simple and easy. Yes, is it clear for you? Did you understand how to do the sum? Please do copy it. Please do copy it. After this, we'll go to the exercise sum, that is question number 17. You should start from there only, no? That is question number 17. 17, 18, 19, 20. If that those sums are over, your test portion, round test portion is over. Sum, I wanted to do into sum, but let you people be clear with these topics. Let me take the end sum afterwards in the second round. Yeah, then coming to the 17th problem of your exercise 1.2. What is the 17th problem? Find the 20th term from the last term. Remember, children, from the last term anta bantu anta matra idan hakbeku. Since the last term is anta kottaga AE formula hakbeku. Since the last term, what is the last term? AN. From the last term anta E formula. Since the last term anta E formula. So, A 20 you should find. Then, what is the AP? 3, 8, 13. It goes on up to 2, 3, 2, 5, 3. Okay, this is A1, this is A2, A3, and this is AN. Is it AN? No, it is L. The value is L. Now, A1 will be equal to A, which is equal to 3. D will be equal to A2 minus A1, which is equal to 8 minus 3, which is 5. 8 minus 13 is also 5. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 5. So, N is 5. Then, from the last term, from the last term and the head, from the last term and the head. So, what is the formula? An is equal to L minus N minus 1 into D. So, what is An? A20 is equal to, L is what, children? 253 minus N is what? Here, what is N value? 20. 20 minus 1 into D is 5. 253 minus 20 minus 1 is 19 into 5. 19 5s are how much? 19 5s are 95. Yes? Yeah, 95. So it is 253 minus 95. 253 minus 95 is 158. Check. Check in your answers. You will have the back answers now. Check there. Is 820 158? Yes, it is 158. Simple sums. Simple. Simple as that. Correct? Is it not easy? Is it not easier than your example sum? The method what they have chosen here and the method what I have chosen here. Is it not easier? So, please do understand. If you understand the concept, that is well and enough for me. Yes, clear? Then, coming to the 18th sum. What is the 18th sum tells you? The sum of fourth term and the eighth term of an arithmetic progression is 24 and the sum of sixth term and the 10th term is 44. Find the first three of AP. So what they have given? Sum of A4 plus A8 is 24 and sum of 6th term and 10th term is 44. Exceed go, sum go, vetyasa ide children. There is lot of difference between the word exceed and the word sum. Okay, exceed and the yes, you need to take plus, I agree. But sum is you need to sum the terms. There exceed means you are the last sum only you saw, no, that I did a mistake. A7 is equal to A5 plus 12. Or you should do A7 minus 12 is equal to A5. So, like that. Here, the terms you are going to add. Then what they have asked you to find? You are going to find the AP. What is the AP that? A1 value, A2 value and A3 value you should find. Okay. This is not 9, 4, 9, 8 and all. It is A4, A8. Then how are you going to write A4? A plus 3D plus, how are you going to write A plus 7D is equal to 24. If you are not able to write it very directly, please do substitute in the formula and write A plus 8 minus 1 is 7, 7D. A plus 4 minus 1 is 3, 3D. And this one, how are you going to write? A plus 5D, A plus 9D is equal to 44. Now, A plus A is 2A plus 7 plus 3 is 10D is equal to 24. Put a colon hyphen. So, A plus A is 2A plus 5 plus 9 is 9 plus 1 is 10, 10 plus 4 is 14. 14D is equal to 44. Both the equation goes in two table. So divide by 2 in both the equation. When you divide it by 2, 2 divided by 2 is 1 plus 10 divided by 2 is 5D is equal. 10 divided by 24 is 12. Colon and hyphen, colon and dot, comma. So 2 divided by 2 is A plus 14 divided by 2 is 7D is equal to 44 divided by 2 is 22. Correct? These are the two equations. Now, as we did in the so many sums like that only, here also, you are going to use elimination method and find the value of AD and find A1, A2, A3. Okay? A plus 7D is equal to 22. A plus 5D is equal to 12. Subtraction symbols cancel. 7 minus 5 is 2D is equal to 2 minus 2 is 0, 1. D is equal to 10 divided by 2, which is equal to 5. So, D value is how much, children? D value is 5. Now, substitute in one of the equation. Either in the first equation or in the second equation, you get A value. So let me substitute in the first equation. A plus 5 into 5 is equal to 12. So A plus 10 G. 25 equal to 12. A plus 12 minus 25. I'm sorry. 13 minus 13. A is equal to minus 13. Correct? So you got A value and D value. A1 is written as A, which is equal to. I'm sorry. B2 is equal to A plus D, which is equal to minus 13 plus 5, which is equal to minus 8. A3 is equal to A plus 2D minus 13 plus 5 into 2 into 5. So, minus 13 plus 10, which is equal to therefore. Therefore, AP is minus 13 minus 8 and minus 8. Clear, children? Is it understood for you? I think this is easier. You have understood how to solve. Yes, let us go to the next problem. That is the 19th problem. Shobarao. Yeah. Shobarao started work in 1995 at an annual salary of 5,000 and received the increment for rupees 200 each year. In which year did his income reach 7,000? Now, they have given in wordings, ma'am, how to find A, D and AN values. See, children, you need to write the statement, then find there is no rules there. Okay. I'll give you the statement, but analyzing, how are you going to analyze? How are you going to analyze? See there, what is the biggest number there? 7,000. So, in the arithmetic sequence, if you take the arithmetic sequence, when will you get the biggest number? Here, the last term you saw, that is 253. In the initial only, you did not get 253. The last term, what you get, it will be your biggest term. That is, AN will be biggest term. So, AN value is how much? 7,000. Okay. What is the next least term? Next least is the first term. That is A. A is equal to 5,000. Then how much is incrementing? Yes, to jaasti after that thinglu. It is the monthly salary or each year. Each year is getting incremented. The same amount has been get incremented. Correct? In the wordings problem, while writing the general form, we saw well, each meter he was giving 50 rupees extra each meter. So each year, here again. So D is, there's how much children? 200. So you got, now you need to find N. What is left here? You need to find N. Hashtag. See, I'm making you to think easier. Wordings barate. When the word problem is coming, wordings will also come. I'll write it in the notes and I'll give it to you. But how will you analyze? Heng kandiditira anadu important. So AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. When you get to know what is the answer you get, then wordings automatically you can only frame. Teacher kodbekantainilla, you only will frame. What is that? Shubharao's annual income salary is A is equal to 5,000 rupees. Then every month he gets increment by 200. So what is the next sequence? You get 5,200. If you add again 200 for 5,200, you get 5,400. That's all. Then what? At which year he gets 7,000? Question mark. Stay. So AN is how much, children? 7,000 is equal to what is A? 5,000 plus N, I do not know, I need to find. Then D is how much? 200. Shall I get this 5,000 this side? So let me multiply this. 200 N minus 200. So you get 2,000 is equal to 200 N minus 200. Let me get this 200 this side. It will be 2,000 plus 200 is equal to 200n. So it is 2200 is equal to 200n. So 2200 divided by 200 is equal to n. So 0 0 gets cancelled, 2 zeros, 2 zeros gets cancelled, 2 ones are 2, 11s are. So at which year he gets in which year he gets 7000? In the 11th year he gets 7000 as a salary. Artha aitna? Understood? How did you do this? Yes, every year it was 200 rupees increment, not 2000. Every year it was 200 rupees increment. So it, when he started, it is 1995. When you add 11 to the 1995, 11 years to the 1995, it will be almost 2008 or 2005 is 10 less one, 2006. In 2006, he gets 7000 has his income. That's all. Simple, right? See, not even half a board. So you need to understand the question, what they are asking. Then if you do this sum, wordings amalinda neeve barkombodu wordings the what is that annual income is equal to dash annual income for this year is equal to dash for annual income for the next year is equal to dash then the total annual income is equal to dash then the wordings. Do not worry if you do not know to frame the words. I'll frame it and I'll give it to you, but understand the concept. Last sum of the exercise 1.2, and this will be the last sum. And all the example sums, everything is being included for your test. That is everyone. So please do learn. Okay, now it is your turn. Now you are going to read the question. Say me which is A, An, and D. I'll do the sum. Then Ramkali saves rupees 5 in the first week of every year and then increases her weekly savings by 1 rupee 75 paise. If in the nth year her weekly savings become 20 rupees 75 paise, find n. So what is an, which is a bigger number here? Which is a bigger number? 5 rupees is a bigger number? No. Which is a bigger number? 20 rupees is the bigger number. So 20th sum, an will be equal to 20.75. Okay, rupees 720.75. Then next number is 5, which is A is equal to 5. Then every week, weekly savings. So increase her weekly savings by 1 rupee 75 paise. So D value is how much, children? 1 rupee 75 paise. What they have asked? Directly they have asked you to find N. See, I have given everything. You need to substitute in the formula and find the value of N. Simple, very simple, no difficulty. So what is an value? 20.75. A value 5, n minus 1, and d is 1.75. if I get this here, it is 20.75 minus 5 is equal to, let me multiply this inside, that's 1.75 n minus 1.75, correct? So in 20 rupees, 5 rupees got over. What happens? 15.75 is equal to 1.75 n minus 1.75. So if the 1.75 comes this side, it will be 15.75 plus 1.75 is equal to 1.75 n. So 5 plus 5 is 10, 0, 1 carry, 7 plus 7 is 14, plus 1 is 15. 1 carry, 5 plus 1 is 6, 6 plus 1 is 7 point, that is 17.50 is equal to 1 rupees 75 paise into n. Now, what to do? It is 17.5 is equal to 1.75 n. 17.50 divided by 1.75 is equal to n. Two numbers, change the decimal points. So we'll be left with 1750 divided by 175. 175, 10s are 1005. So totally in the 10th week, She will be having 20 rupees 75 paise as her savings in her savings account. That's all. Okay, so this completes the exercise to 1.2 with the formulas of these. That is the general formula A plus A is equal to A comma A plus D A plus 2D up to A plus N minus 1 into D. And general equation is A plus N A as T. A N is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. When are you going to apply for all the arithmetic progression? You are going to apply this except when they ask you to solve the given problem from the last Adanta statement bantu onde. When they ask you the statement, solve the given problem from the last, then only you are going to use AN is equal to L minus N minus 1 into D. What is this L? The last value. What is this AN? AN find out. Which term you should find out? That one. D is as usual a common difference. Then here the word problems only hege, how you are going to find out AN, A, D, you have come to know this. Correct? Yes, I hope you people have understood. You felt very easy with these problems. So please do practice right from 7th question or 6th question. Please do write each and every problem in the classwork as well as in the homework and practice to your exam test. Okay. Thank you very much, children. Thank you very much. All the best for your test. In the next class, I'll be telling you the telling you the pattern of your test. I hope you do not require, because the question paper comes to your home itself. You'll take it to your home. Then also, it's okay. Thank you, children.